I fell in love with Shakuhachi about a year and a half ago, and it's not been an easy love. I'm not one of those people that this came naturally for. It took me like a month of practicing Ro every single day before I could even get a reliable, crappy tone out of the flute, and probably another year before I could get reliably get a decent tone out of the flute. And I mean, the notation also, I couldn't figure out the associations with those tones, with, it's like this is this tone and this is above that and stuff. And when I've heard other people play Shakuhachi, yeah, this was love at first sight, really, or at first sound. I love the way the instrument sounds. I love the way that it feels to play it. And I wanted to get to be able to enjoy playing that rather than fighting, trying to learn the notation. Anyways, then the lockdown happened, and I was like, well, I could either start Skyrim again, or I could take this extra time that I've got on my hands and study programming and see if I can make the kind of tool that I want to be able to help me learn how to do this stuff. And so this is what it is. So the application actually runs as a WebGL app. So all you do is open a web browser, http colon slash slash emilykingfineart.com slash Shakuhachi. So you could use this if you wanted to on a smartphone, like when you're out and about. I wouldn't recommend it. This screen is so small, but you could do that. I mean, this actually is the app. It does stuff. And this is just going to be a quick overview, just to get you acquainted with this. I'm going to be going and doing more in-depth, tutorials, especially for people who are brand new to Shakuhachi, because I needed a heck of a lot of help when I was just getting started, and I still do, because I'm still pretty much just a noob at this. But yeah, if you want to go through the QuickStart and help file, the link is directly below the app, and you can go through that and find the ins and outs of the application. So, super quickly, this beige area, that is the tablature window. That shows the tablature that you'll be reading and practicing. The measures are read from top to bottom, and the column measures are right to left. And as you see, it kind of, slides in, and new stuff is written and fills in, replenishes the leftmost column. The columns are numbered in Japanese numbering. And if you wanted to change that from Japanese to Western numbering, you can do so from the main menu. I'll get into that in just a second, because you can also hide that little circle, the playhead, that shows you what note you should be playing. You can hide that from the main menu as well. But before we do that, these sliders on the right-hand side of the tablature sheet, that is what you use to set the tempo. And you can see the readout on the metronome there, which you can hide if you want to by clicking on it, and reshow it if you want to unhide it. And you can change the volume of the notes that are being played all the way down to nothing, which it's actually a really good practice. I highly recommend that once you feel comfortable with stuff. And you can increase and decrease the level of the metronome volume down to nothing if you want. So, yeah, the settings, the default settings that it comes in with, I find that that's actually a pretty good practice if you want to practice the lower register of the Shakuhachi. If you want to make changes, well, let's go into the main menu. And this, of course, is where you would show and hide the playhead, and also switch over to Western numbering if you want to. Now, if you're like, hey, I am beyond the basic Shakuhachi scale, with fully open holes, I'm going to get some merry practice in, click on a note in this scale that's darkened, aka deactivated, and you'll add that note to what the computer has available to compose music. I hesitate to call it music. Noise? Sound? Whatever. Compose that you practice with. Click on a note that is active, and it'll deactivate it. And those test tones you can deactivate those test tones from this little menu, from this little checkbox there. But if that test tone thing is active, then you can slide the scale root left and right, and you can hear the scale played for you, so you can see if that's really what you want to be practicing or not. And the scale root tells the computer where to start that long note to start your practice, if you're doing scale practice, and get into the swing of things. And yes, technically I know that this is incorrect, but I haven't yet thought of a better way of describing this to people who know what they're talking about, and the computer, and myself, who is still just learning this stuff. You can also choose scale presets here to choose different scales and have fun with that and whatnot. These range sliders are what you would use to set the high and low ends of the scale that you're practicing. Say, for instance, you're just starting out and you only want to do row. Well, put your high note, your high end, there so that it's not going to play these notes because they're deactivated, they're not part of your active scale. So going back to the main tablature window, you'll see that all we have access to is row. So that's a good way to get started. If you can do row and you're like, I even want to learn, the names of the notes. You can just add tsu and then just come back here and just actually say ro, tsu, ro, etc. You have access to the high and low range sliders here as well on this window. And as you see, I just added re, and now re is an option that we have to play here and practice. Bring it all the way up to the right, and we've got, the full standard issue range of the Shakuhachi. And then that brings us into these step sliders. The small step slider, and these are the step slider and note length, these are just probabilities. All the way to the right, it's high probability. If I bring this, then you've got two things that are high probability. It's as probable as choosing one is the other. But the small step, very, very quickly, basically that means it's going to just try to usually go from one step to the adjacent step as it's trying to compose this stuff for you. Now, it will sometimes throw in some tricky things in there because I wanted to keep me on my toes. Because otherwise, I'll just guess what it's going to do and instead of actually reading the music, and I need to learn to read this stuff. So bring up the medium step probability slider all the way high, and it'll jump over a note to the next one, usually. So you see it's going from ro to chi to tsu in the upper octave, and then he, and etc. And you probably guessed what big step does. It jumps over two notes in the active scale. The same concept, let me bring this back down. This is, by the way, what I find to be most helpful is to have the small slider all the way up and the medium slider just a little bit up so that I occasionally get a medium jump over a note, and that keeps me on my toes. So the note length, I'm using Western terms here because that's easiest for me to wrap my head around. So whole notes, reset score. By the way, the step sliders and note length sliders, they will come into being if you're actively practicing only to replenish. It uses this information here to replenish the leftmost column as it's writing, stuff for you. So like if I bring up the probability of half notes, then it'll start writing in half notes. And you see it slides over. I try to get it to slide slower, but, like I say, I'm a painter, not a programmer, so, yeah, I'm doing the best I can. And, but if you want to have the whole score regenerated. Just press reset score, and it'll recalc everything based upon its current settings and pause playback and switch back to measure one, ichi, and then give you a count in and etc. So bring up the probability for quarter notes and just, I'll leave that in there. So it's now probable of doing a whole note, quarter note, half note, etc. Eighth notes, you see that the circles which indicate whole beats are changed to tick marks, which indicate half beats. It'll be one and two and three and four and you've got a line down the center of the tablature of the notation, indicating that those notes with a line down the center of it, those are eighth notes. And you see that that's actually a whole beat on the offbeat, kind of like, you know, it'd be, well, let's just hear it. Okay, so we've got the count in, and we've got a whole note here, and let's slow this down so I can talk over this. So there'd be one, and three, and four, and. And if you want to really challenge yourself, 16th notes are experimental. I'm not 100% sure how to write them in and have it look decent, so click that button. You can expose that slider on your own lookout, and you can increase that, and you can get some 16th notes, which are indicated by a double line down the center of the notes. So these, in Western terminologies, would be counted 1, E, and, 2, E, and, etc. So that's the quick lowdown for this thing. Play with it, have fun, make yourself laugh, learn in the process, and I hope that it helps you as much as it's helped me. I've worked this in, like after I do my opening, 5 or 10 minute row to just kind of get back in the vibe of Shakuhachi. I'll set up something, not too terribly challenging, like this, maybe a couple of eighth notes, maybe a little bit more than that, not that many. And I'll just practice this at the beginning of my practice. And just doing that, it kind of makes it almost like a game. And it's made a difference just over the course of a couple of months I've been practicing with this. And at the recommendation of one of my senseis, I have actually just been taking my smartphone and just being like, oh, it's super tiny, I can't really see the sliders, but I'm going to practice saying these notes out loud. And I'm actually beginning to remember not just the names of the notes, but also the interrelationships of the pitches. But, anyways, have fun with this. Hope it makes your life a little easier, and that you can get to the good stuff of actually playing the music more quickly and not fighting with remembering the tablature and stuff. Anyways, thank you, and cheers.